So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to make your very own crafts for your small animals. But I have two special guests which I'm about to show you. This is guest number one. This is Bonnie. Bonnie is a female guinea pig and she's not quite a year old yet. And she's a lovely, lovely white and ginger colour. So that's Bonnie. And Bonnie lives with another guinea pig, which I will show you. And this guinea pig is called Tea Cake, and I will get a closer up video of her. So Tea Cake is very unique, and she has spiky fur, and she is a tri-coloured guinea pig. And she is also not quite a year old yet. Making your own crafts for your small animals at home is very simple and it's really good because it saves you a lot of money and they can be just as fun for your animals to play with. First of all, I'm going to be showing you what you can make out of a simple egg box. Now, this is going to be great for your hamsters and gerbils. It is a perfect size to make a little house for them and I'm going to be showing you how. So with this egg carton, you can do whatever you want, be creative. Also remember, because we're using scissors, you should get an adult to help you if you're very young and just be really careful. So I'm just going to be cutting different holes and different little entrances to this egg box, and this will be great for gerbils and hamsters. It'll be a really good little hideout for them and they'll really enjoy this. So we'll start with this bit here where the lid is, I suppose. I'm just going to cut out a little bit of a square here. So there you can see we now have the first entrance, which leads to this little hideout. And now I'm going to start cutting some holes on the top. About it looking neat, it really doesn't matter. And that's all you have to do, it's very, very simple. You can change little bits of it if you want to be creative, or you can make the entrances bigger if you have like a bigger hamster. So it's a really, really quick one that you can make and I'm sure that they will love this. Next up we have toilet roll tubes. Now everyone has these. Again, this is another really simple one to make. So you'll just need a kitchen roll tube and several toilet roll tubes. So then this is going to stay as it is, but you're going to flatten toilet roll tubes and put them into the kitchen roll tube. And you're going to make it more difficult for them to get inside of the tube, and then you're going to fill it with different treats. You'll probably get the hang of it once you've seen me do it. So this is going to just make different sections within the tube, and then they really have to work for their food. Thank you. see, there's now different sections in there. You can fill it with maybe dried herbs and things, just to make it more of a challenge for them. We also have plastic bottles. Now you wouldn't really think these could be used for anything. So you want to use a clean plastic water bottle. First of all, you should take off the label if there is one. Now what you want to do is make different holes all the way around. Remember, you should definitely get help from an adult if you're young, because this is going to be quite hard to do by yourself. So try to keep the circles smooth as you can so your rabbits or guinea pigs don't get injured on the plastic. You can do triangular shapes if you think that will be easier. Cut more out if you want to make it easier, or do less if you want to make it more of a challenge for them. But also make sure you do keep the lid, because when you fill it up with treats, you're going to put that back on and then they can roll this around and try and get all the treats out of it. So it's a very simple and a really fun toy for your rabbits and possibly your guinea pigs. You might want to supervise them when using this, just to make sure they don't start chewing on any of the plastic. We also have some kitchen roll tubes, and these are also in most people's homes. So using the kitchen roll, we're also going to get some safe twigs that they can chew on. This is going to work really well for rabbits and guinea pigs. So you could use willow sticks or hazel sticks or anything else that is safe for them to chew on. And then you're going to take your kitchen roll tube and very carefully poke some holes in it. So once you've made all of the holes, you're going to go and push one of the twigs through it, and it should go through the other side. And then what you want to do is add some vegetables to this, and it helps if they're in this sort of shape and they will just slide on much easier. I'm also going to be showing you what you can make out of just a tissue box, again an everyday household object, and this is going to work really great for rabbits and guinea pigs. So what you want to do is get a piece of cardboard which is going to cover up this gap here in the tissue box. I'm going to poke two holes into this bit of cardboard, and this is what is going to attach to the string. So then you're going to cut off a piece of string, and you want about this much string to go on the top, but then cut off a little bit extra because you're going to tie that underneath. So then you want to put the string through the hole that you just made and then tie a double knot at the bottom. And there you go, and that's the lid. So you can fill this with different treats and things. And this will work really well for rabbits, maybe not so much for guinea pigs, but you could definitely give it a go. And once you put the treats in, you put the lid on, and they have to work out that they have to lift this lid up to get the treats. Finally, I'm going to be showing you what you can make out of these brown paper bags. This will work for rabbits, guinea pigs, gerbils and hamsters. So it's great for a variety of small animals. So all you need to do to make these forage bags is to fill them up with loads of hay and different treats. You should put all the nice treats at the back and then fill it with lots of hay, and then they can forage in here to try and find all the yummy treats. You can do the same, well, this works well with rabbits and guinea pigs, but you can do the same for your hamsters and gerbils. You could scatter all of their food into one of these bags and maybe fill it up with bedding and possibly some soft hay. And they will really enjoy searching for their food, and that'll be a really good activity for them.